After having upgraded to Windows 10 from Windows 7 or Windows 8, Windows 10 becomes slow and laggy no matter how good system resources a PC has. Instead of looking for ways to fix sluggish performance and boost overall system speed, most of Windows users prefer to go back to Windows 7 or Windows 8. I have also gone through this same terrible situation. When I had upgraded to Windows 10 from Windows 7, I used CCleaner, updated and reinstalled drivers, uninstalled and reinstalled all necessary programs. I uninstalled my antivirus hoping it will fix the issue. Even I tried every possible way to fix sluggish performance, but nothing seemed to be working. I then decided to clean install Windows 10 and fortunately, it worked and I felt dramatic changes in overall performance and speed. In today's video, I will be teaching you how to clean install Windows 10 after upgrading from Windows 7 or Windows 8. Let's start off with the necessary things. Though Windows 10 installation process takes 30 to 40 minutes to be completed, but there are few very important things you must take into account before going for a clean install. You need to have the ISO image of Windows 10, a USB pen drive with minimum 8 GB of free disk space. You can also burn the ISO image to DVD disk if you want, but I personally suggest you to use a USB pen drive. Most important thing is your data stored in partition C. Clean installation wipes out all files and folders from drive C. Therefore, don't forget to backup or move your important data to any other hard drive partition, external hard drive or USB pen drive. After the clean install, although you don't need a product key if you have upgraded from Windows 7 or Windows 8, but you need to activate your copy of Windows 10 and other softwares you've bought. Just to be on the safe side, write down your product key and serial keys of softwares you've bought, as well as you can do so with Wi-Fi key. You can use a key finder to swiftly find the Windows product key and serial keys if you don't remember or know of. In addition, if you don't use a Firefox or Chrome account, then important backup bookmarks, usernames, passwords and other details if you use the internet. As you might know that, a computer is a set of various devices, and you need to install drivers to make them operational after a new or clean install. Download all necessary drivers to avoid any inconvenience, specifically Wi-Fi drivers. We now need to download the ISO file of Windows 10. We have two download options. You can use Windows 10 Media Creation Tool or direct download from the official Microsoft website. I recommend you to use Media Creation Tool to download Windows 10 installation files to make a bootable DVD or USB. Download Windows Media Creation Tool and launch it. You may find the download link in the description. Keep in mind, you need 16 GB free disk space in drive C. Apparently there is no option to change the download location. Click accept. Since you are going to clean install, therefore select create media for another PC and click next. If you want to clean install on this PC you are using right now, then leave it as it is. Otherwise, remove checkmark from use the recommended options for this PC. If you want to download it for another PC, select your preferred language. The most important thing you need to take into account is download Windows 10 version you bought or upgraded to. I'm using Windows 10 Professional Edition and going to select Windows 10 from the drop-down menu. Windows 10 option contains Home and Pro editions. Select both from Architecture drop-down menu and click Next. Choose USB flash drive option if you want to make mere bootable USB. You need a USB flash drive with 4 GB free space. I recommend you to use 8 GB USB flash drive. If you want to save the ISO image on hard drive for future use or to burn it to a DVD disk, then select the second option ISO file and click Next. Now select download folder and give it a name if you want and click Save. Congratulations! Download is now complete. We now need to make a bootable USB if you had chosen ISO file option. You don't need to make a bootable USB if you had chosen USB flash drive option. I use a free to use USB creator Rufus to make a bootable USB to install Windows. Plug the USB flash drive with 8 GB space into your PC. Keep in mind USB flash drive will be formatted and you will lose all data. Download and launch Rufus. You may find the download link in the description. Click the CD-ROM icon to select Windows 10 ISO image we've downloaded earlier. Select standard Windows installation and click Start. Bootable USB is now ready. I do hope you've backed up your data stored on drive C. And I'm going to clean install Windows 10. Plug the USB flash drive into your PC and restart. Swiftly press boot menu key to bring up boot menu to boot from USB flash. For an example, in Dell desktop PCs and laptops, F12 key is a boot menu key to bring up boot menu to boot from USB flash. Press any key to boot from USB flash drive to kickstart the installation process. Here you can choose your preferred language and keyboard or input method. It's no necessary though. Click Next. Click Install now. Put in the product if you've bought Windows 10 from Microsoft or any other place and click Next. Click I don't have a product key if you've upgraded to Windows 7 or Windows 10. After the installation is complete, Windows 10 will automatically be activated online using digital entitlement. I'm going for I don't have a product key. Since my version is Windows 10 Pro, therefore I will be installing Windows 10 Pro. Select your Windows edition and click Next. Accept the license terms and click Next. Since we are doing clean install Windows 10, therefore double-click on Custom. Here we need to format the drive C. Select drive C and click Format. Keep in mind it will delete all files from drive C, so pay close attention to all the process. After the format is complete, select drive C and click Next to install Windows 10. For me, the installation process took 34 minutes to be completed. It could be more or less for you depending on system resources. Your PC has. You now need to install all necessary drivers and make other preferred settings. I do hope you find today's video helpful and informative. You may ask me anything if I could not explain anything properly or you run into any problem using the comment section. I will be trying my level best to solve your problems. Stay tuned, stay blessed, and don't forget to like, subscribe, comment and share.